الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده وعبد الله مخلصًا له الدين حتى أتاه من ربه اليقين فصلى الله عليه وعلى آل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى صحابته الأخيار وعلى التابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Brothers, sisters, our life is too short that we have to use every single moment in our life to build this life and to build the other life. We are here in this life for a test, and whatever we are going to do here, it is recorded in our page in the hereafter, and we receive what we done here in this dunya. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam always encourage the believers, those who are around him, and the Muslims, and the all mankind. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is the seal of the messengers of Allah, and he is the final prophet that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him, and he sent him not for Arab, not for non-Arab, but he sent him for all mankind. Ya ayyuhan nasu inni rasulullahi ilaykum jami'a. Oh, the people. He didn't mention the Arab. He didn't mention the Bedouin in the Arabia at that time or the people of Mecca. He called all mankind. Oh, people, I am the messenger of Allah to you. So whatever the Prophet ﷺ say, it is a revelation from Allah. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us that our deen is built on the Quran, which is the pure words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the accurate sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to guide those who will follow this message of peace that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in the Quran. The Prophet ﷺ always tried to encourage to do good in this life. And one day the Prophet among his companion, he said, who will take from me these words, learn it and teach others to learn it and to act with it? Immediately Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, he raised, he said, I am the messenger of Allah. You know, Abu Huraira is one of the closest companion to the Prophet ﷺ. Even his convert to Islam is very late. But he used to accompany the Prophet whenever he leave his home, he is with him. And to listen to him, to understand from him, and to memorize. And beyond the memorization, he used to write what the Prophet ﷺ used to say. So when Abu Huraira stand up, the Prophet ﷺ took the hand of Abu Huraira and told him these five important words. We'd like to go through these five important words. We try to learn it. We try to apply it in our daily life and to convey this message of the Prophet ﷺ to others for benefiting others. The first advice that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Abu Huraira, number one, ittaqil maharima takun a'bada an-nas. Avoid the prohibited things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited in the Quran, you will be the highest one who worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will mention the five, then go by one according to the time, inshaAllah ta'ala. اتَّقِ الْمَحَارِمَ تَكُنْ أَعْبَدَ النَّاسِ. Avoid and abstain from any prohibit things which come in the Quran and in the Sunnah, you will be the highest worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one. Number two, وَرْضَ بِمَا قَسَمَ اللَّهُ تَكُنْ أَغْنَى النَّاسِ. Satisfy of what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you. The staying that Allah azza wa jal give you, and be sure that whatever you get in your life, it is that Allah love you and He give it to you. Satisfy of what Allah give you, then you will be the richest one. You don't need to put your hand to anyone else but to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, وَأَحْسِنْ إِلَىٰ جَارِكَ تَكُنْ مُؤْمِنًا. Do a favor and a good action and a good way of communication to your neighbor, you will be a good believer. Number four, وَأَحِبْ لِلنَّاسِ مَا تُحِبْ لِنَفْسِكَ تَكُنْ مُسْلِمًا. Love to the people what you love for yourself, you will be a Muslim, because Islam is a way of life and Islam is for all mankind. That's why all mankind should be and will be one family, because we all related to one father and one mother. Whatever you love for yourself, love it for your other one, for people that you live within. By this way, you represent Islam in the best way. And number five, وَلَا تُكْثِرْ مِنَ الضَّحِكِ فَإِنَّ الضَّحِكَ يُمِيتُ الْقَلْبِ. Do not laugh a lot, because laughing a lot, it will affect your heart, and your heart may be dead because of that. So let us go one by one. The first one, اتَّقِ الْمَحَارِمَ تَكُنْ أَعْبَدَ النَّاسِ. Avoid the prohibited things, you will be the highest worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jalla prohibit many things in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ for our benefit. And there is a wisdom behind anything that Allah prohibited. Wisdom number one, avoid associate anyone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jalla said in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَنْ يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. We need to build a good relationship with Allah, with the Creator, because we in need of Him every single moment in our life. He gives us an eye to look, He gives us a tongue to speak, He gives us an ear to hear, He gives us whatever we in need in our life. وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. So we need to build this good relationship between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's why we haven't to associate anyone with Him. قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. And so the first prohibit, the wisdom of a prohibit things, to build a good relation with your Lord, the one who created you and the one who shaped you while you are in the womb of the mother. Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَوِّرُكُمْ فِي الْأَرْحَامِ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. He is the one that He shape you while you are a baby in the womb of the mother. He is the one who shape you. So we need to build a good relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number first. And that's why avoid shirk. And a part of the shirk is the show off. Some people will do things not for Allah Azza wa Jalla, but for people to thank them. Some people pay that they hope that people, they said, oh, this is a generous. Some people, do something good that the people will say that he is a good man. No. Whatever deed you do in your life, do it only for Allah Azza wa Jal. And don't look after the thank of people. Look after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will look after you, because He is the one who will reward you. Number two, why Allah Azza wa Jalla prohibit things is for the benefit of our body. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He is the one who created us, and He knows what is good for our body, what is bad for our body, and that's why in the Quran He prohibited many things in the Quran for benefit of our body, as Allah Azza wa Jalla said, حرمت عليكم الميتة والدم ولحم الخنزير وما أهل به لغير الله والمنخنقة والموقوذة والمتردية والنطيحة وما أكل السبع. All of these محرمات among the animals that Allah prohibited for us because for the benefit of our body. The pig is a haram to eat because there is something affect our body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited for us to eat on a dead animal because the dead animal will affect our body. And Allah prohibited us to eat the blood because the blood affect our body. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited us to eat a certain kind of animals like lion or certain animals that it will affect our body. That's why Allah azza wa jal hurrima. I said hurrimat alaykum is very clear. And if we avoid that, then we will be following the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So because of our body, Allah azza wa jal prohibited many kinds of animal, many kinds of food that we have to abstain from it. Number three, why Allah prohibits something? Prohibited because of the benefit of the family. The family is the first circle of the society. If the family built in a good way, then the society will be in a good shape. And that's why Allah Azza wa Jal prohibit for us in the family to protect the family, as Allah said, حرمت عليكم أمهاتكم وبناتكم وأخواتكم وعماتكم وخالاتكم وبنات الأخ وبنات الأخت وأمهاتكم اللاتي أرضعنكم وأخواتكم من الرضاعة. Allah Azza wa Jal in this verse, he give a details that if you are within the family, your mother is haram to get married, your daughter is haram to get married, your sister is haram to get married, your aunt is haram to get married, the mother that feed you from her breast milk, it is haram to get married with her. This is for the protection of the family. Imagine, a'udhu billah, if the family, the father married his daughter, what will happen? It is a problem. It is a very big problem that we Muslim has to clear it, to clarify for all other nations that may fall in this big sin of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they fall in. And that's why Allah prohibited all of this, to keep the family in a clear, in a purify the family. Number three, number four. The prohibited things, it come in the Quran, is for the benefit of the society, to keep the society in a secure way. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal prohibited stealing, and the one who will steal, he should be punished, because the money of the people is protected, the soul of the people is protected by Allah and by the Quran, and the dignity of people is protected by Allah Azza wa Jal. That's why stealing is prohibited, adultery is prohibited, terrifying others is prohibited. The terrorist people, they have a very big punishment in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tried to secure the societies of the mankind. And he said in the Quran, إِنَّمَا جَزَاءُ الَّذِينَ يُحَارِبُونَ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَسْعَوْنَ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَسَادًا أَن تُقَطَّعَ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَأَرْجُلُهِمْ مِنْ خِلَافٍ. Anyone who terrify the society, anyone who affect the and go beyond his limit to make a corruption in the society, he has to be stopped. And the Quran give a severe punishment of those who make corruption in the society, and they have a bloodshed in the society, and it is prohibited totally, because Islam protect five things of mankind. Protect the dignity of people, that's why adultery is haram. Protect the soul of people, that's why killing others is haram. Protect the money of people, that's why stealing is haram. Protecting the deen of people, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that, you know, man sha'a falyu'min wa man sha'a falyakfur. So number five, Allah prohibited things to keep the rights of others, the rights of the human right, the the human life, the human right is protected in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, especially for those orphan people who do not have one that he may support them. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ mentioned 7 major sins that is prohibited in Islam. The Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, اجتنبوا السبع الموبقات, avoid the 7 موبقات. The موبقات is the sins that it may dip the person in hellfire in the day of judgment. What are these 7 that we have to avoid? Number one, الشرك, which is very major sin. And number two, السحر, the magic, we have to avoid it. Number three, killing the innocent soul, it is prohibited. Number four, أكل الربا, the misery, and it is prohibited. Number five, التولي يوم الزحف, that to escape from the battlefield of defending your deen, is prohibited. And number 7 is to accuse the innocent lady, that to say that she commits something wrong, a shameful deed, but she didn't, and this is prohibited, and there is a specific punishment for those who accusing other with no right and with no document of that. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited many of those in the Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-A'raf, قل say إنما حرم ربي الفواحش ما ظهر منها ما بطن. Say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited the shameful deeds, whether this is in hide, whether it is in open, ما ظهر منها ما بطن, والإثم والبغي بغير الحق, وأن تشركوا بالله ما لم ينزل به سلطانا, وأن تقولوا على الله ما لا تعلمون. So this is the first words that the Prophet ﷺ told Abu Huraira to learn it and to teach it to others, to apply it in daily life. Number two, وَرْضَ بِمَا قَسَمَ اللَّهُ تَكُنْ أَغْنَى النَّاسِ. The reality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one who created us, and He is the one who gives us what we need in our life, and that's why we have to rely on Him fully. Whatever it comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to go through the reason. As Allah mentioned in Surah Tabarak, فَاسْعُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا. We have to go and work. We have to build life. We have to do our best to build this life according to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. It's very nice hadith when he said that, إِذَا قَامَتِ السَّاعَةُ وَفِي يَدِ أَحَدِكُمْ فَسِيلَةً فَلْيَغْرِسَهَا. Even if the time, if the day of judgment will happen, and in the hand of you, a small tree of palm tree in his hand, go and plant it. Even the palm tree, it needs more than around 20 years until that it will give a fruit. And this is the way that how the Prophet ﷺ encouraged us to do our best and to rely on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why we have to accept whatever comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank Him of what He gave us. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned a very nice hadith regarding this point. من أصبح منكم آمنا في سربه معافى في جسده عنده قوت يومه فكأنما حيزت له الدنيا. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned in this hadith that any one of you, if he is in the morning, wake up in a secure family, in a secure society, in a secure place, he doesn't fear anything else, and his body will be healthy, he is not sick, and he has, if he opens the refrigerator, he has a food for the day or for a week, then as if that he owned the whole dunya. That's why we have always to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers, we sometimes open the refrigerator and we have a food for a month. Imagine and a people now living in a border between Syria and Turkey, those refugees who left their homes fearing of war, they even doesn't have a clean water to drink. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are living in the best place, we are living in the best country, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought us here to practice the deen of Allah azza wa jal and to convey this message of peace for all people. Number three, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned to Abu Huraira, أحسن إلى جارك تكن مؤمنا. Do a good for your neighbor. Regardless of your neighbor is, regardless of his deen, regardless of his nationality, regardless of his color, regardless of his language, your neighbor is your neighbor. You have to do the best to your neighbor. And the Prophet ﷺ warned that the one who will not do a good to his neighbor, he will not be a good believer. The Prophet ﷺ mentioned in the hadith, Wallahi la yu'min, Wallahi la yu'min, Wallahi la yu'min. It is very big warning. I swear in Allah, he will not a believer. I swear in Allah, he is not a believer. I swear in Allah, he is not a believer. The companion pay attention. And they say to the Prophet ﷺ, who? Oh, the messenger of Allah. Then the Prophet ﷺ respond, قَالَ الَّذِي لَا يَأْمَنُ جَارَهُ بَوَائِقَهُ. The one that his neighbor will not secure from him, that his neighbor fear him, that he cheat his neighbor. This one, it get out of the circle of Iman. This is to show how the neighbor is very important in our life and to take care of them. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in another hadith that the Prophet said, Jibreel always encourage me to do a good for my neighbor, encourage me to do a good to my neighbor until that I think that maybe the neighbor will inherit his neighbor. Subhanallah, in the hadith. And in the other hadith, Man kana minkum yu'minu billahi wal yawm al-akhir. The one of you that he will believe in Allah and in the hereafter, fala yu'dhi jarah. He must not harm his neighbor. Harming neighbor is prohibited. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيُكْرِمْ ضَيْفَهُ. And the one who will believe in Allah and the hereafter, he has really to do a good and to host his guest and give him the best. وَمَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. And the one who will believe in Allah and the hereafter, فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُدْ. He either say something good, beneficial for others, or he should keep silent. Because whatever we say, there is two angels will record it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. Whatever you say, it will be recorded. Either this is for your benefit, you will happy with it in the day of judgment. Or if you say something, maybe it will make a conflict among people, it will make a corruption in the society, then you will be charged in the day of judgment. Number four, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged the fourth word, that أحب للناس ما تحب لنفسك. Love to the people what you love for yourself. Brothers, sisters, we are all mankind related to one father and one mother. We should live as a one family. We should love others as we love to ourselves, because this is Islam. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned in this hadith, if you love for others as you love for yourself, you are the Muslim, because this is Islam. Islam is the way of life. Islam is the message of peace. Islam is the message of a human right. Islam is the message of a brotherhood. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةً. And the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, لا يؤمن أحدكم. No one will reach to the high level of Iman حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه, until that he will love to his brother as he loved for himself. And number five, ولا تكثر من الضحك فإن الضحك يميت القلب. Do not increase and laugh loudly and more and more, because this will affect your heart. One day the Prophet ﷺ, the companion, they saw the Prophet ﷺ little bit show the sadness in his face. He said, oh, the messenger, what's going on? Then the Prophet told them, لو تعلمون ما أعلم لضحكتم قليلا ولبكيتم كثيرا ولخرجتم إلى الصعدات تجأرون إلى الله. Because the Prophet ﷺ invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a journey of Isra and Mi'raj, and he saw what Allah prepared to the bad people in Jahannam, in hellfire, so he be sad that he tried to pull the people from the ignorance to the righteousness. The Prophet ﷺ always think about what is going to happen to the people who disbelieve in Allah, the people who ignore the message of Allah Azza wa Jalla, what Allah prepared them in the hellfire. Can you imagine the people of the hellfire when they ask for a water because of thirsty? Allah said in the Quran, فَسُقُوا مَاءً حَمِيمًا فَقَطَّعَ أَمْعَاءَهُمْ. The people of the hellfire, when they become very thirsty and they ask for a water to drink, then the angels will give them and a boiling water, it will cut their intestine. In the other side, see what is in Jannah. In Jannah, there is a rivers of clean water. There is a rivers of wine, but not like the wine of dunya that it takes the mind out. The wine of the hereafter, if you give you a highest happiness, but you keep in your mind. A rivers of clean water, a rivers of wine, a rivers of honey. Can you imagine? A rivers of yogurt, of milk. This is what Allah prepared for the people of Jannah. But Jannah is not cheap. Jannah, it need a work here in this life before you move to the hereafter, and we don't know where we're going to transfer. No one of us sure that he is going to live for tomorrow or not. And that's why don't wait, the death will come to you. Prepare yourself before the death is coming. At that time you cannot say, no, please, the angel of death, let me just pray, let me just pay, let me just do something good. We have to prepare ourselves. One of the companions, may Allah be pleased with him, he dig a grave in his house. And every day after Isha, he lay in that grave and he talked to himself. This is the hole that you are going to be buried sooner or later. You don't know what you are doing, and to prepare for that moment when the angel of Malakul Maut, the angel of death, will come to separate your soul from your body. Those who will prepare, they will be very happy. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزُنُوا. Those who will believe in Allah Azza wa Jal and stand fastness and do their good in their life, in the moment of death, the angels will come to them and give them a good news. Don't worry, don't fear. The angel of death is coming to you. So don't worry that you are in Jannah. And that's why they will be happy. As Bilal, may Allah be pleased with him, in the moment of death, his wife, she is crying as she said, what should we do? The pain that I... Then Bilal opened his eye and talked to his wife. Don't say wa karbata, don't worry. غَدًا نَلْقَ الْأَحِبَّةِ مُحَمَّدًا وَصَحْبَةِ. Tomorrow we are going to meet the love people that we love them in our life, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the companion. And this is the last moment of those who believe in Allah, avoid the haram in their daily life. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والتائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. إبراهيم بن أدهم, he is one of the scholars that he used to teach student. One of his student, he came to him one day and told him, Sheikh, my soul is pushed me to commit adultery. I cannot hold myself. He is young, and you know, his soul will push him. Inna nafsa la ammaratun bisu. What should I do? Then the sheikh tried to give him this advice. He said, student, if you would like to commit the sin in a place where Allah will not see you. He said, wow, where am I going to go? And say, if your soul push you to do a sin, get out of the land of Allah. Say, where am I going to go? If you would like to commit a sin, don't eat the food of Allah. Don't drink the water of Allah. Say, what should I do? Then he told him the last one. If you commit the sin, okay, When the angels of hellfire will take you because of the sin that you commit, they will take you to the hellfire. Tell the angels that I'm not going to go with you. They said, I cannot do that. Then at that time he realized, when the shaitan influenced the person to fall in sin, then he realized that there is two angels who record, and there is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who look, and there is Allah who see. And that's why, subhanallah, Musa alayhi salam, Moses, when Allah commanded him to go to Pharaoh and to give him the message and to tell him about Allah Azza wa Jal, Musa alayhi salam, may Allah be sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, oh Allah, I fear Fir'aun. Maybe he will kill me. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa, innani ma'akuma asma'u wara. I am with you. Musa and his brother Harun, I be with you. I hear what is going to happen, and I look for you. Don't worry, go and give Fir'aun the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يطهر قلوبنا من الذنوب والخطايا. We ask Allah عز وجل to clean our heart from the sins and from the dhunub that it may make a veil between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enlighten our heart by the right faith and the right guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided to us in the Quran and in Sunnah. Allahumma inna nas'aluka wa natawajjahu ilayka fi hadhihi as-sa'ati ash-sharifah al-karimati al-mubarakah an la tad'a lana dhanban illa ghafartah wala hamman illa farajtah wala daynan illa qadaytah wala maridan illa shafaytah wala 'asiyan illa hadaytah. اللهم إنا نسألك ونتوجه إليك في هذه الساعة الشريفة كريمة مباركة يا أرحم الراحمين أن تهدي أهل أمريكا إلى صراطك المستقيم. اللهم guide this society to your road, to your steadfast word. Allah, oh Allah سبحانه وتعالى, we ask you that to guide all people to a peaceful deen. Oh Allah سبحانه وتعالى, we ask you to off all the war in the world. Oh Allah سبحانه وتعالى, we ask you to take care of all the problems that it happened in the world, to off it and to end it. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you to save all mankind from any bloodshed that it happened here and there. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you to apply peace in here and everywhere in the world. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ya arhamar rahimin. Allahumma fi ad-dayn 'an al-madinin. Allahumma ighfir hawaij al-muhtajin. Allahumma nafis al-karma 'an al-makrubin. Allahumma shafi wa 'afi mardha al-muslimin. Rabbana atina fi ad-dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina 'adhab an-nar. Allahumma harrim bi lutfika وجوهنا جميعا عن النار. عباد الله, إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر الموحدين. ولذكر الله أكبر, والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.